So thank you for giving opportunity to present our integrated database and analyzed database in this in our post-grad study our project. So my name is Soichiro Mishima, and first of all, I thank the NVIDIA and DBCLS to keep hosting this biohackathon series. So it is very good opportunity to know each other, I think. So I'm very happy to welcome biohackathon 2014. Here in Sendai, Matsushima, as a local organizer. And following a presentation by the Nagasaki-san, so I briefly introduced data and knowledge integration in our database. As you know, the Alzheimer's disease is the most common cause of the dementia among the elderly people. I have been studying the molecular mechanism of this disease and using the biotics and systems biology approach. But with the advent of the aging society, so also in Japan in 2015, so that's a more population aging rate is estimated to be the 40.5%. The cost for caring and caring the increased number of the people with Alzheimer's disease will rise dramatically, and thus will be the great burden, the historic burden to our societies. On the other hand, that a higher quality of the medicine to Alzheimer's disease with lower cost is demanded. So that to address this social issue, so that predictive, personalized, preventive and participatory medicine is urgently expected. And as you know, that the former speakers already mentioned, that a great earthquake occurred on the 11 March 2008. So called the Great East Japan Earthquake. So to revitalize medical care in the disaster area, so that our organization has been established, and I joined this project. It aims to become a center for the reconstruction of the entire Tohoku region by conducting some prospective genome cohort study and developing the large-scale genome biobank towards a personalized prevention and medicine. How to realize the personalized prevention? Personalized medicine. So that's first of all, the gene environment. Gene means the variants and the environment is the exposures, nutrition and lifestyles. So that the gene environment interactions causing the common disease should be clarified. So as for the variants, low frequency variants with intermediate effect, is our main target. So that to achieve this, to reduce the gene environment interactions, we conducted a prospective gene cohort study by collecting sample and data. In our organization. So that's, as you can see, that's as for the species samples, so the blood and green is now collected, and so as for the baseline program data investigation, so that's the questionnaires and the physical measurements and our test is ongoing. And as for the genomic data, the analysis already mentioned, and I think that it's related to the question by the former speaker. So that the clinical data will be collected by using the Miyagi Medical and Welfare Information Network, MME. It's a kind of a medical network of the hospital. And that's sample. This slide shows the sample and data flow in the Tohoku Medical Megabank. And the in our prospect for study, we will recruit 550,000 people at Tokyo University and satellite and hospitals and health clinics. And we collected these kind of things as explained in the previous slide. And collected the data and samples will be identified and stored into the database and the freezers. And I would like to talk about this data integration in my talk. So this is the overview of the database in the Tohoku Medical Megabank. So that is very busy slide, so I would like to focus on this integrated database and knowledge database in my presentation. So integrated database is a database of the for the integration of the genomic omics and the specimen and the baseline plot and the clinical data like this, so that these data are de-identified. And the knowledge database is for the integration of the existing and the knowledge, novel knowledge by the large scale correlation analysis of our collected data. So, and we already built the pre-release version of integrated database and will be available with keeping security under our security policies. So our security policies is designed for the security of the data, type of the data, so the personal data, strong and standard security policies. And as I told, in the integrated database, we have this kind of data. So very vast amount of data and some very various data. So, and the, as for questionnaire, so that there is 20,000 items for each person. And the, as for the blood and visual status data, so that there is 10,000 items for each person. So that we collected these data and stored into the database. So, and the, however, so that it is very hard to grasp the characteristics of the data. So that's like it's so huge, so that we cannot download the data and we cannot have a seek in the Excel file or something. So that's it's very hard to grasp the characteristics of the data. But before starting the research, we need to know that we'd like to know that the characteristics, for example, the distribution of sex or distribution of age or something. So that's So therefore, the integrated database not only provides an integration of the data, but also provides a statistical significance and the related knowledge in cooperation with the knowledge database. So, and the knowledge database, here, so the integrated database, so that the integrated database has a cooperation with the knowledge database, and this database not only integrated, but also provides a statistical significance to characterize the population or to provide a related knowledge. And the knowledge database stores the existing knowledge of the personalized and prevention and medicine. And as for, we also have an NLP support system to extract knowledge from the literature. And we also have, we also store the novel knowledge by the large scale correlation analysis. And the integrated database is relational database and implemented by the Oracle and the MySQL DBMS, so DBMS. And the other hand, the knowledge database is implemented by the RDF triple stores, so that's made by the virtuals. Statistical significance provided in the integrated database, right? This is a test data. So, for example, if you search the integrated database by using this breast cancer keyword, so you can narrow down the population having the pathogenesis of the breast cancer. And you can see that the sex, age, blood test, or some of these kind of the composition of the populations. And the database also provides a statistical significance to know that the bias of this population. For example, this breast cancer, you know that is mainly happening in the body in the female, so that as you can see that there is a bias in the sex composition. So most of the sex is a female, and so it's just a test data. So and the, also you can see that bias in the alcohol intake, so that so breast cancer, how to say, population having breast cancer have a kind of much more alcohol intake, so rather than the entire population in the database. So and so that we can know that this database provides a characterization of the selected population, and I expected that this will be the kind of hypothesis for the researchers. And of course, this kind of things is very important to keep the privacy. So that's like, if you want to do the, this kind of analysis, we need to have a whole data in your computer or the system. So, but the, if the database system equipped this kind of function, that's that we can avoid this kind of that, data, how to say, avoid the key loss of the privacy. And the database also has provide knowledge, related knowledge incorporated with the knowledge database. This is the same example, so that if you narrow down the population with the breast cancer, and in this case, there is a facet view in the database, and this provides a related knowledge like this. For example, as you know, the breast cancer has already have have a highly linked and the positive SNPs like this, so that you can check this kind of related knowledge already reported in the literature. So that's and the provisions related to knowledge of selected data by Spark Query to the knowledge database. And we think that this will promote the study of the personalized prevention and the medicine. And the, this is also the function of the knowledge database. So that we will provide the population classification like this, so that it's in, how to say, we are now modifying this function right now, so that it's insufficient, but as for example, this is an example of liver cancer, so that's red point, red circle correspond, indicates the case group, and the blue corresponds with the control group, so that you can see that the similarity of the populations like this. So this kind of things is very helpful to graph the characteristics of the target populations. And the, this is a very important point, so that our project collected a sample and data provided by the living people. So, and we have a three-generation cohort study. In the case of the three-generation cohort study, newborn baby is also provides the data and sample to us. So that's the, to keep the data security and is very important in our project. So, and the, therefore that our integrated analysis database is, how to say, we need to provide a function to keep the data security and the data privacy so in the integrated database and knowledge database. In a project, we are aiming at the personalized prevention and the medicine. So which kind of disease will he or she have onset of, and so within which kind of rate consequence will he or she follow, so that of course we can calculate risk of onset of disease. However, the most common diseases are caused by the multiple and complex factors, and the evaluation risk of onset of disease is not straightforward. So, but we are getting have a large scale biobank integrating the clinical data and the laboratory measurements with follow-up pathogenesis data. So with accumulated genetic and clinical and environmental profiles, so we believe that we can approach this. So we can approach to this problem by using the two approaches. So that's the first one is the logic and reasoning. So that's if we can make knowledge in the knowledge, we can represent the knowledge in the structured way. In that case, we can store this kind of data in the RDF stores, as you know. And the, of course, I think this approach is not enough for the classification of the population and the prediction of the pathogenesis of the population. So that's we think that another approach is important. That's machine learning, classification of disease and disease subtype by using our data. It's a kind of unstructured data we think. And in this hackathon, so we hope that we can, how to say, so we can have a very unified and integrated way of the human genome resource in the RDF format. And we hope we can realize a kind of a personalized prevention support system based on our accumulating knowledge for the personalized prevention and the medicine. So I'd like to acknowledge the Clinic Megon Association and my department. And it's at last, I'd like to say that welcome to Sendai and Matsushima. So we will move to the Matsushima. So, and in Japan, it's a very good season so that you can enjoy this, how can I say English? So that in Japan, it's the Koryo. So in So, and in Entsuin, in Matsushima, they are now doing the kind of the light-up in this month, so that you can enjoy this very beautiful landscape, and please enjoy by our pastor. Thank you.